Hello, my name is Devon Adana and I am the CEO of Hello Tobago. And on this channel, ht.bizisland, I absolutely love helping Caribbean entrepreneurs use Instagram to promote and market their business. All right, so today what are we talking about? Today we are talking about whether or not you should be creating a separate Instagram page for your business, right? You'll know that Instagram allows you a personal page and a business page. In fact, they allow you as many pages as you want, but your phone will only allow you to manage 5 on your phone, on your device. But you could have as many Instagram accounts as you want. But as a business owner, should you be creating a different page? Can you run this from your personal page? Now, many of the gurus out there are going to tell you, yes, you can. Yeah, well, they're going to tell you, no, you shouldn't, right? That you should get a page dedicated to your business, right? But I would not be so hasty. I have 8 factors that we are going to walk through today. These are 8 questions that you really need to be asking yourself before you make the decision on whether or not to create that separate business account. Now, we're going to keep these videos nice, tight, and packed with value. So let us get straight into it, all right? So these factors, I've kind of separated them out into kind of like 4 major topics, right? So what we're going to really be dealing with is we're going to be dealing with the issue of selling. We're going to be dealing with the issue of newness. We're going to be dealing with the issue of confusion or bacchanal, right? I know you want to know about that one, right? And then we're going to be dealing with the issue of time, okay? So let's get straight into it. Selling. The first question you want to ask yourself is, who are you selling to? Okay, so hear me out on this. I think this is one of the most important questions that you need to be asking yourself, probably even before you deal with what you are selling, which is question number 2. Spoiler alert, sorry about that, right? So yeah, so who are you selling to? Most important question. If I want to sell to rich people, but I'm currently being followed by not so rich people, then we're gonna have a bit of a problem. I'm not going to be successful on Instagram because the people following me aren't exactly the people that I need to be selling to, right? So you want to really identify your target market. You want to know who they are, right? And are they already following you? Now, if they're not already following you, that's okay, right? And let's say you do make the decision. You say, even though these people aren't following me yet, I am going to go ahead and use my personal page for my business as well, right? You have 2 options, right? The 2 options is either, right, you figure out some way to get that type of follower following you really quickly. And you could do that with ads, right? With either paid ads or on Instagram or Facebook itself, or you could run an ad on an influencer's page. Do not buy followers. I know everybody says that, but please do not buy followers. It will just, it's just not a good idea. It could mess up your, not only your rating with the algorithm, right? But it also messes up your page because you're not going to get the type of people that you need to get anyway. And I don't care how many places promising you that you will get, or we could give you people who are interested in travel, or we could give you people interested in XYZ. That does not work for us in the Caribbean. Why? We are on these small islands. It's very hard for them to get those targeted followers that we need, especially if you have a brick and mortar business, right? It's very difficult for them to get the exact kind of customer you need, meaning the one on your island that you need to be talking to. So just don't do it. It just don't make sense for us, right? So that is one, right? So one way is to identify paid methods of getting your ideal follower and or following your personal account. Or the other way is to just let time take care of it, meaning win them over slowly, right? So you could either win them over fast, meaning go to these influencer pages, run ads that speak to that person and bring them in, or win them over slowly, which is win them over with your content, provide the value that they need, and over time your page will transition from a personal page, right, or a page that a lot of your personal stuff is on, into a business page, right? Now, there's one other thing that I could throw in here, which is, even though that it's the people who you need to be selling to aren't necessarily following you yet, you may be, let's say you are a person who is already of some influence outside of social media. So let's think of some of the major politicians on your island, or somebody who already has influence outside of. So it could be a business, you may be a business owner in another realm, not online, and you have that influence already. So you may just start your Instagram page as a personal page and have all the people who would have normally been around you and wanting to and craving information about your life, right? So let's say you're a soca artist or a dancehall artist, but you've never been on social media. That is quite possible, right? So those types of people will have people flocking and running to them as soon as, right? They will just be like, hey, as soon as they start up, you know, so and so at Instagram, people like, oh my God, they will just come running, right? So you kind of bring the real world onto the social media. So that is also an option too, meaning if you have that type of influence. But for us small business owners who are on here, we need to be thinking of this as either a fast game or a slow game if the people who you want to be selling to aren't already following you. All right? Okay. Number two is, what are you selling? Yes. So let's say you mostly have friends and family following you on your page, right? And that's fine. That's good. That's cool, right? But let's say you're selling makeup. Now, and now look at see, I don't have a stitch of makeup on my face. I don't know nothing but makeup. And this, I'm sorry, this is what you get. This is what you get. I just don't know nothing about it. Or you ain't gonna get much out of me with that, right? But anyway, I digress. So, right. So let's say you sell makeup. But you are like the only person in your family who is obsessed with makeup. Nobody else cares about makeup. Nobody else into makeup. So it means that if your friends and family following you, it's going to be kind of hard to convert them into the people that you need. Now, one of my favorite Instagram business coaches, I don't know if you're familiar with her, but her name is King Ashley Ann. She always tells you that your friends and your family do not have your money. Strangers are the ones who have your money, right? And that makes sense. Friends and family, they love us. They may buy one time, but they really aren't our recurring money. They're not like a recurring customer or recurring client. They purchase because they love us, not because they love what we do, right? And so you're going to run into the same problem if you decide to start running your business stuff to your friends and family. I know you're thinking to yourself, but I already have a following of at least 1,000 people on here, Devon. Why is it that I have to now go and start from zero? Don't let starting from zero ever stop you from doing something that you really are just, you really want to do, or you're really compelled to do. Okay? So if the people you want to sell to are not already following you, then it is going to be really, really, really hard to make the money that you're trying to make. And we're trying to make money. The reason I'm doing all of this is that you can make money, right? We're in a pandemic right now. A lot of our islands cannot sustain the kind of economic downturns that we've been seeing. Why? Because we're heavily dependent on tourism, and it is very difficult to run any kind of profitable tourism in a pandemic, right? So we really want to ensure that we are creating the kind of businesses that could run online independent of the fact that we live on these most beautiful and amazing islands. All right? Okay, so let's get into number 3 and 4, which are all about newness. Yes, they're about the new, right? So the question is, number 3 is, are you new to business, right? Now, listen, you may have just come up with your business idea and you are super excited to just hit the ground running, create the Instagram page, create the Facebook page, on TikTok. Yeah, right? Sounds good. But remember, as a new business owner, there are a million and one things that you will need to think about. And the least of them, at least in the beginning, will not necessarily be the marketing. You may be trying to get your processes in order. What happens when a customer comes in and they purchase? You're probably going to try to get the back end of things really up and running before you say, okay, yeah, let's go gung-ho on the marketing, right? Let's create a whole new Instagram page and let's really get people all involved and excited about the brand. Yes, all of that is important, but remember, as a new business owner, you're just going to be dealing with so many competing issues that you kind of want to make sure that starting a new Instagram page is not going to overwhelm you. All right? So, listen. I understand. Money likes speed, meaning you get the thought in your head to start the business, you jump in one time, right? And I agree with that. That has a place and a time. But you have to be sensible if you're going to move forward with this, right? Yes, the universe loves those speedy action takers. And speaking of action takers, I am going to ask right now that you take action by turning that little gray bell down there blue, okay? So I'd love if you like the video. And while you're at it, you might as well just subscribe. And let's just throw this out there. Also, tap the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my videos. Yeah. Right? Okay. So I know as a newbie, you want to take action by creating an Instagram page that's dedicated, but you just have to think about all the other issues that as a new business owner you will come up on. There may be regulations that you didn't think about. There may be all sorts of things in the pepper sauce that you was not catering for. Okay, so right, number four is, are you new to Instagram for Business? So you may not be a new business owner, but you're new to Instagram for Business specifically. And trust me, I know that your tanti, nenen, cousin, baby brother's friend who is a social media manager told you that all you need to do is put up your page on Instagram and people can just start following you like that, right? Yeah, okay, so it doesn't actually work that way. It requires a little bit more thinking and processing to run an Instagram page. So if you're new to Instagram for Business, you may want to test out some things with like a burner account, right? So that's one of the pieces of advice that I give to new business owners, well, at least newbies to Instagram, is create a burner account, a burner business account, meaning just, you know, kind of like a waste business account now, to test out things, to see how things, how you could deal with the flow of it. Of course, you could start up your page and deal with the flow right there on your page, make the mistakes and do all the crazy things and still have a successful page. But in the beginning stages, you may not want to do too many missteps, right? Like I did. Trust me, I have made all the mistakes, people. And yeah, don't worry, we're going to talk about all of that. Right? So yeah. So, you know, your success really hinges on, you know, can you bring people to your Instagram yard, right? So your Instagram, to your business page is really like the milkshake. And you're gonna be testing different milkshakes. People mightn't like chocolate, okay? People mightn't be feeling a coconut milkshake, a mango milkshake. Yes, there's a mango, right? Listen, Olya, I love mango so much. It's like my favorite food. It's never very far away from me. In mango season, I am there. Okay. All right. Digressing. Right. But yeah. So you don't want to bring your personal account kind of behavior to your business account. And what I mean by that, right? When we have a personal account, we kind of post when we want. We post pictures of the babies. We post pictures of the new car. Things that your business people following you aren't necessarily going to be interested in. Right. So you don't want to bring in personal account attitude to the business account. We don't want to be doing that, right? We want to make sure that our attitude is the business hat and we are serving our audience the value that they came to our yard for, right? So you need to be creating a kind of milkshake that makes sense. And if you're new to Instagram for Business, you may not always be knowing what is that value, what is the milkshake that I need to be creating to bring these people to the yard, right? So that's something to think about. All right. Now we're getting into, of course, my favorite part, the confusion and the bacchanal. Okay, all right. That was my attempt at like a soca. I was trying to give you a little Zestra mixing with like a Allison, a little Heinz there. Okay, all right. So it's confusion and bacchanal. Now, with confusion and bacchanal, there are really three questions here. The question is, are you going to be easily confused by running your personal page as a business page, right? Because some days you post about the car, next day you post about the business. Oh, I told them I was going to give them 5 steps to do this, and I had to go back and see which post. Oh God, this is too much. I ain't even going to post, right? Sounds familiar. I know some plenty of them doing that, you know, right? So are you going to be easily confused? The second question is, will your audience be easily confused? Let me tell you something about a confused audience, okay? Confused people never buy. Once I'm confused and I don't know what's going on, I is not buying nothing, okay? So you want to make sure that you're not confusing your audience. Because what are you going to put in your bio? Mommy of three sells, I don't know, mangoes? I just saying, right? So you don't want to overwhelm and confuse your people, right? The third thing is, are you going to confuse the algorithm? You do not want to be confusing the algorithm, people. The algorithm is our friend. We need to be helping the algorithm help us. The algorithm is going to be searching your page and saying, people who love mangoes seem to like this page. I need to go out there and get more mango loving people to come to this page, because clearly this person talks about mangoes a lot. But if you're also talking about the baby, talking about the car, talking about the fact that you graduated yesterday from school that has nothing to do with selling mango, then you're going to be in real monkey pants, right? Because the algorithm is going to be like, wait, what? I don't know what she is talking about, so I'm just not going to do anything, right? So this is the same confused audience. You don't want to confuse your audience, and you definitely do not want to confuse the algorithm on Instagram, right? So now we are at number 8, and number 8 deals with time. People, it takes time to build your know, like, and trust on these platforms. I know you hear people talking about know, like, and trust, KLT, all the time, but it is true. This is like any other relationship. You now see a fella or the other way around, you now see a girl. You ain't want, the relationship doesn't just build. Yes, there is love at first sight, but you still have to build a relationship, honey, okay? So this is something that takes time. And do you have the time to dedicate to building a brand on Instagram and building a brand in real life, right? Do you have that kind of time to dedicate to it? So these are the 8 questions that you really want to be asking yourself. Now, listen to me, right? I know that a lot of this Instagram for Business thing is new to you, and that's okay. Me and you, we starting a relationship, all right? I am here to guide you through this. So here's the thing. I create these t-shirts on Redbubble. If you don't know what Redbubble is, it's like a t-shirt or merchandise store. You could get aprons, you could get masks, you could get all sorts of things on Redbubble, right? And so I create merchandise that's centered around Caribbean female economic empowerment. So it's all, you know, it's t-shirts like the CEO, so they're a little bit sassy, but you know, they're all also about fempowerment. So if you want, not if you want, I will be linking below, right? In the place where I get to link things, there will be a link in there for you to be able to get the CEO t-shirt and other merchandise that I have going on. Guess what? I have a new video starting, and it starts right